Hello guys, what is up? It is me, the real Rebel Games X5 here. In today's video, guys, as you can see, we are reviewing the Hapog HD PVR gaming capture thing. And guys, pretty much what this is a screen recorder for your Xbox One, PlayStation 4, PlayStation 3, or Xbox 360, or Wii. And pretty much what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how to set it up, and it's really simple. And what it's going to look like on our computer so you guys don't get worried and stuff. So to start off, as you can see here, we have the device itself. It is a box like shape thing, and all you need are these four cords. Two HDMIs, this cable that comes with it, and this other power cable that comes with it. So for purposes of showing you how it works, I'm going to unplug these cords, and I'm just going to show you where they all lead to. I'm not going to like unplug them completely and show you how to set them up, but what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you. So, pretty much what you're going to do to start off is, sorry guys for that pause. What you're going to do is you're going to take your HDMI cable going to your Xbox 360, One, or PlayStation 4, and you're going to plug it into the HDMI in. As you can see, it says there. It is a little bit blurry here. I can try to focus it there. It says HDMI in. You're going to plug your cable into that, and yeah, that's pretty much it for that step. Next, you're going to take one going to your TV, and you're going to take that cable, and you do the exact same thing, but you're going to plug it into the one next to it, the HDMI out. Here, I can try to focus in on that, but it's a little bit too dark. So, yeah. Next, all you're going to do is you're going to take this cable that came with it, you're going to plug it into the back here, and you're going to run it in. See, so I have all this cord here. All this leads right here to a USB somewhere in my computer. It does not have to be a laptop. It can be any computer, as long as you have the software downloaded. Now, guys, there's only one more step after this, except for downloading the actual software. So now all you have to do is take this cord right here, and all you have to do is plug it in right here. See? And once you do that, that green light should light up. If it doesn't, your power cord may be broken. I have no clue. I have never run into that problem. But next, guys, all you have to do, this is a very simple step, download the software. All you have to do is look it up, go to their updates on their page, download the newest software, and this is what it should look like. This is the most recent one. And pretty much what you're going to get is you're going to get this record button, you're going to get all this. And I could go over all the features, but you guys can look all that up, and you can select your mic, your audio and stuff, and it's really cool. Now, one thing you may think, oh my gosh, what's happening? Is my thing broken? So as you can see here, it shows everything that's happening on the screen. Oh my gosh, guys. Okay, so it did just barely freeze as soon as I did that. So I'm actually just going to exit out of the software real quick. And that is what the little thing looks like when you download it. And see, it's going to pop up. Everything is going to say, like, loading. See, it's loading your stuff. And your thing should be glowing green when it's ready. And if you actually, here a sec, just give it a moment. See, it is doing everything that's doing on the Xbox, but see you guys, if I scroll down on the Xbox, it doesn't do it automatically on this. See, it just barely went to zombies, guys. The reason why is that is because this computer is not fast enough to keep up with the speed. It's okay, guys, it's not going to ruin your audio or anything, it's not going to do any of that. It's not going to record slower on this than it is there. It's just because your computer's not fast enough. If you have a faster computer, it will do it exactly the same time, but it's not going to ruin anything if you have a slower computer. It's just going to take a little bit longer to respond for you to look at. That's all it is, guys. It's not going to do anything else other than that. So, yeah, guys, this is a complete how to use the Hapog HD PVR, how to set it up, and what the software and stuff is. And that's it. And actually, guys, let me show you. You can edit your videos. It's really simple editing, but it is editing, which is cool. See, and you can just do your files in there. There's a YouTube thing, so you can upload stuff to YouTube. There's a stream, so if you like to live stream. And they just barely added Facecam in, which I'm going to be experimenting with, because I do have a camera and stuff that I can do Facecam with. And yeah, guys, that is it for today's how-to tutorial. Again, guys, if you enjoyed today's video, leave a like, comment, and subscribe, and we'll see all of you baby otters in the next video. Peace.